This is the video to help you complete the freefall experiment. In this experiment, we'll be dropping a coin from different heights. We're going to use post-it notes to mark different heights at 30 centimeter intervals onto a wall vertically above a sounding object. I am using a textbook as a sounding object. In the late 16th century, Galileo used bells to time the progress of a ball rolling on inclined plane to study kinematics. We're going to use a similar method, but using modern technology. We're going to use a free software called Audacity to record the sounds created when we release the coin in a particular way and when it hits our sounding object. By looking at the recorded sound, we can precisely time the or precisely measure the time it takes for the object to fall through a set distance. The software is free and can be downloaded from the Audacity website. The website also has information on how to install the software. To allow the start time to be recorded accurately on the sound recording, we release the coin by placing it onto a ruler such that the coin is hanging off the edge. We then use a pencil or a pen to sharply tap the ruler so that the coin then falls off immediately, coincidentally with the sound of that tap. And that marks the start time on our audio record. When the coin hits the sounding object, that will mark the end time. Here I'm going to show you how to use Audacity to record the experiment. I'm taking my coin and I'm balancing it on the edge of my ruler and placing it at 30 centimeters above my sounding object. I'm going to press record on Audacity. It is recording right now. And the waveform that you can see there is from me talking. I'm going to be silent and then I'm going to tap the ruler, allowing the coin to drop onto the sounding object, and I will repeat the experiment 3 times. I'm going to stop recording now. Here's my recording, and I can always play it back if I'm not sure what the sounds are. I believe that all of this was me talking, and my actual experiment starts here. I can verify that by playing it back. Yes, that indeed was the coin drop. What I'm going to do, I want to measure the time interval between when the pen was tapped and when the coin first hit the sounding object. It's easier if we zoom in to the audio waveform, and we can do that by pressing this button. I can scroll my audio waveform using the scroll bar at the bottom. Again, I can place my cursor here and I can play the track just to make sure the sound is what I think it is. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is click on the beginning of the sound that marks the start of the tap with the ruler, which is what releases the coin. The reason it's not a sharp tap and that there is some width to the waveform, maybe due to the microphone response and also resonances in the room, etc. So what I'm going to do now is to select from the beginning of the tap to the start of the sound that marks the point when the coin first hits the sounding object. And that's this time interval right here. When I go down to the bottom, I see that this time indicator is indicating length. So I want to make sure that this radio button here is checked. Reading this value here, we see that the time interval for the selected section over here is 0.265 seconds. So that's my first result. I'm going to now scroll over to my second coin drop. Here it is. And do the same procedure. My second result is 0.279. And my last result here is 0.261. I want to explain what these sounds here are. These are due to the bouncing of the coin on my sounding object. So we want to do this to get good results. We want to make sure we accurately start at the start of the tapping sound, where my pen taps the ruler that releases the coin, and our selected region ends at the start of the sound that comes from the coin hitting our sounding object. We repeat this experiment for all the different heights, and for each height we do 3 coin drops and get 3 values. I hope this helps.